we serial killers are your sons. We are your husbands. We are everywhere. And there will be more of your children than tomorrow. These are the famous words said by Ted Bundy on January 24th, 1989, before his execution. So psychopathy is one of the hardest disorders to spot in a person, because most of them are handsome, they're smart, and they're quite charming. So learning about psychopathy will give us a better understanding of how it affects us and the world around us. Okay, so I will talk about now how psychopaths affect the world around us. And okay, first of all, I will talk about how psychopaths affect the world around us, what their motives for killing are, and why they believe what they are doing is good for mankind. So many psychopaths, so a psychopath is someone who believes that what they're doing is right, and they always have their motive for killing is to find pleasure. And most of them believe that what they're doing is right. So some of them kill prostitutes, and they believe that that is right because they're purging the world of their filth. Then others believe that they are God. And in the book, The Psychopath Test by John Ronson, Peter Woodcock was given they tried to cure him. They tried to cure psychopaths. And he was one of the examples, and they tried to cure him. And they believed that they cured him, so they finally gave him his 3-hour pass. And in that first 10 minutes, he used it to kill one of the inmates in there. And when he was interviewed later, they asked him, why would you kill someone you love? And he said, I just wanted to feel what it felt like to kill someone. And then the interviewer asked, but you've already killed 3 people. And he said, yeah, but that was years and years ago. So it shows how, in his case, he can be cured. His illness can be cured. And then in another case, it was in a book by Harvey Kleckley, published in 1941, it's called The Mass of Sanity. He describes how psychopaths are, they're intelligent. He describes the characteristics of a psychopath, that they're intelligent, charismatic, charming, they lack remorse, they have neurotic manifestation and poor judgment. And many of them just, this is how they lure their victims, since most of them are charming. Like, you wouldn't expect a charming, handsome, young, educated man to actually be crazy or be a psychopath. So I discussed the characteristics of a psychopath and how they reacted to being cured. Now I will talk about why they love what doing what they do and what gender psychopaths are. In the psychopath test, one of the guys, Joseph Fredericks, when he was released right away, he went off and killed, he was believed to be cured, and he was released and he went off to kill an 11-year-old boy. And when the cops found him holding the boy's lifeless body, he said, why did he have to die? He was so nice. So his motive was just to hurt the kid, but since he loved the pleasure of it, he hurt him to an extent where he actually killed him. Okay, and then for many of you have heard the Chainsaw Massacre. So that movie is loosely based on Ed Gein, who murdered and disembodied women. But what many didn't know that he did because he wanted to be a woman. So he would wear women's breasts and genitalias, and he wanted to be a woman, but he didn't really know what gender he was. And in a source by CNN, different attempts to creating psychos. I've talked about different types attempts to creating psychopaths. Let us now explore the meaning of this problem and how it affects the world. So psychopaths are a threat to society because we don't know who could be a psychopath. It could be your next door neighbor or a friend. And most psychopaths have the same motives to kill for pleasure, but some of them, they justify what they do by that they believe that they are God, or they believe that what they are doing is for the good of mankind. And as in the psychopath test, in a study by Kelly Daniel from CNN, she says that 1% of men in the United States are psychopaths. And it also said that there are also women psychopaths, a 1-to-20 ratio. And so that means anyone could be a psychopath, or like any person that you didn't think could be a psychopath could be a psychopath. And so first I talked about the meaning of first I talked about what a psychopath is, then I talked about different ways of thinking, and lastly I talked about how it affects the world around us. So as Ted Bundy said, they could be a loved one. So next time you're talking to someone or you want to be friends with someone, remember what could happen to you, because you could end up 6 feet underground.